I'm going to talk to you the subject called Deliverance Prayer for Spiritual Disease in Double-Minded Mind. There is a disease called spiritual disease in double-minded. People with the double-minded mind, they have very serious sickness. They have very serious disease. And it is a spiritual disease. Some people, they don't know. They found themselves, they are double-minded. Double-minded believer is someone who is constantly living in a state of compromise. Compromise. Welcome. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Ziggy. Welcome you from Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry, Brampton, Toronto, Canada. Welcome. As I'm going to talk to you this topic, it was a difficult topic. I tried to put it properly, to arrange and get the scriptures and meditate upon the scripture. I thank the Holy Spirit, who is a teacher, who is a helper, who helped me to bring this title. I hope you will be blessed and God will help you. People are living in double mind and they don't know what to do about it. A double-minded believer is someone who is constantly living in a state of compromise. A half of your lives for God, while the other half life lives for your bad habit. Unless you are double-minded. This is the way some people they live. They live halfway in God, halfway on the devil. So you find a believer, a Christian, they still feasting with the doctors. They still feasting psychic people. So these are the people called double-minded mind. They are unstable, the Bible called them. As you consider whether or not that experience is described, is there, the scripture is talking about the double-minded person. Is a character. Is a characteristic of a double-minded believer. Let's look at the characteristic of double-minded believer. They are believers who still visiting psychic people. They are believers who still visiting false prophets. They are believers who are still visiting witch doctors. They are two major influences which fuel your thoughts life. Your thoughts are fuel. There are some powers of darkness that is fueling or that is making you to do what you are doing. That is spiritual diseases. There is a disease has entered into your mind. When that spirit entered in your mind, it tells you, it gives you direction because you don't believe in one part. You are a devil. You believe God and the devil. You believe there's some things that you can't stop because with double-minded, they can't stop this. They think that they can help themselves because God says help. God help those who help themselves. But you know, God does not say that you will help him. God is the one to help you. Now, because of double-minded, then you think that when you do like that, you are helping God and you are helping yourself. A double-minded Christian is always being taught into two directions. He has a relationship with Christ as his Lord and Savior, but he also has a relationship with the devil, or particularly sin. Some Christians, some people with the double-minded, they have Jesus Christ as personal Savior. They give testimony. They are good when you talk to them. Before you finish talking, they can preach to you 10 scriptures. They know the word of God. They can talk to you until you keep quiet, you watch them, because they will make sure that they know God and they can make you to look a fool. People calls me here. Before I talk, they can preach to me so much scripture. Now I ask them, I see you know the scripture, you know everything. So why are you calling me? I need you to preach to me. because such a people, they end up suffering and being mistreated and rejected because they have double-minded. As many of you have seen the news in the TV, in the Facebook, wherever, this pastor who committed adultery and he ended hanging, committing suicide. After he was found, he ended up committed suicide. So double-minded is a sin. It's sin that makes a person to live with it. He serves God and at the same time is serving the sin. He's serving God and at the same time is serving the devil. So once you allow that demon or disease of double-minded, it will waste your time. And there is no power, there is no one who will remove that except you yourself. You have a history with both of your major influence. No Christian becomes double-minded overnight. No Christian becomes double-minded overnight. It takes some time to develop and letting desire to pursue particular causes or cause. But make no mistake about it. History has always of repeating itself. History repeats itself until we apart ways with that thing which is slapping at Jesus. All the time we continually find ourselves in a state of in trauma. So the double-minded, it does not come overnight. It doesn't start to come like that straight away. You've been thinking in your mind, it is in your mind. And then because you are on the Lord, you are on Jesus, and you are in the devil, so the Holy Spirit is telling you, no, don't do this. Double mind tell you, go ahead, because that is how you can help God. So you find that it is a thing that started from inside. It is the thing that started long time. Now it grow as you continue giving power, it grow until it comes out. Even if you have worked with the Lord for years, double-minded life would eventually come to you and find you. You see, a pastor of the church, he decided to commit adultery. That thing was, it did not start overnight. It didn't start from him just a day or something just come. It was in him. It was in his mind. He was preaching and looking to these girls. That thing has been in him because he has double-minded. He did not give his mind to Jesus fully. Now, when you find yourself compromise your thoughts, life, in one particular area, Satan has at his craft for many centuries, and just as he knew what target, what attracts people. Satan is a craft. He crafts people. When he sees that your mind is double, so he will say, good, you are a good candidate. So he will try all his best to move to your life. He will assign the demons, his agents, to be close to you, hand in hand, working with you hand in hand, until you are influenced in full. Now when you enter full, then you enter into the sin. Because you are serving God and you are serving the devil, now the sin will overpower you and take you full. You become their property. When you become the property of the devil and you are serving Jesus, they will not accept. They will refuse. They will say, we don't share. You must serve us. You must be in our life. Because this thing, it did not start overnight. It was there until it comes, until you gave it permission to enter full. Now, when they enter full, the devil is in charge of you. Once the devil is in charge of you, it tells you now you are ours. Therefore, you cannot serve that man, that person, and you serve us. That's why you see people backslide. people, they go back to the world. A child of God who was singing, a child of God who was praising God, who was preaching. I know a lady, she was very, very powerful, very hot preacher. She was destroying demons. She was praying and people were healing. People were crying in a meeting. When she calls a meeting, thousands, so many people were coming to her meeting. But one day, this girl decided, she's from no reason, she's, I don't know, because these things, it seems it was on her mind. She decided to quit and go to serve the devil. She quit the church and went to the world and changed herself, dressed like a prostitute, dressed like a person who is on the market. She changed suddenly. Many people cried and said, if this woman can do like that, then there is no God. So many, many people, even they backslid because of her. They loved her and they believed on her, what God was, how God was using. So many people backslid because of her. Some people, they said, then there is no God. If this woman can change like this. We have seen many. Even Saul, the prophet of God, who was anointed by Samuel. This man, when he started, he's double-minded. The Lord left him. And he ended up in going to help, to get help from the devil. When he went to get help from the woman, the witch, the woman said, okay, because you have come here, you will never serve any other God. That's why God had to kill him straight away. God hates double-minded people. If you look at the book of James 1, verse 8, the Bible says, being a double-minded man, unstable in all his ways. Once you become double-minded, you will be unstable. That is the characteristic of double-minded. You become unstable. You cannot achieve anything. You can't do anything. That is why this double-minded, it becomes so hard. Then it attack your mind, and then you end, some people end up suffering from schizophrenia, suffering from depressed, suffering from demonic attack because of double-minded. They don't want to stay. They don't want to stay in one side. They stay too double. Then they, once it is overwhelmed, you end up being serving the devil. It is unstable mind. That's what James says. James said it is a double-minded, unstable in all his ways. Once you are double-minded, you are unstable. Unstable, you cannot do anything. You become powerless. You start visiting place to place. The devil is looking at you. It is a disease. It is a spiritual disease that you need deliverance. You need to cry to God to help you, to deliver you from these spiritual diseases of double-minded. It is unstable. You cannot be settled to one place. You need help. Instead of getting help, you wander so many places. You visit church to church. You go and correct some spirit of those churches. You go to preacher, you correct something from them. Now, when you correct all this, you become unstable. Nothing working for you. Unstable. Because nothing is working for you. Not that you are not praying. You are praying, you are fasting, you are doing everything. But because of double-minded, then you become unstable. All your ways become unstable. James 4 verse 8, the Bible says, draw near to God. James 4 verse 8, the Bible says, draw near to God and he would draw near to you. Cleanse your hands, you sinners, and purify to your heart, you double-minded. So the Bible says, come near, even if you have been going there, but there is a chance. God wants to help you. God wants to deliver you. The Bible says, cleanse your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded. Purify the heart. Purify the heart. The Bible says, you double-minded. because you will suffer and being you will suffer so much if you cannot draw near to God, if you cannot seek God and stop sinning. Because double-minded, you serve God and sin. So you have to kill sin and serve the Lord. Then God would have mercy upon you. Psalms 119, verse 13 to 15. The book of Psalms 119, verse 13 to 15. The Bible says, I hate those who are double-minded, but I love your law. You are my hiding place and my shelter. I wait for your word. Depart from me, evildoers, that I may observe the commandment of my God. You see, the Bible says you have to hate the double-minded. You have to pronounce it. You have to confess and say, you double-minded, get out of my life. I hate you. I hate you because you would make me to go to do things I am not supposed to do. You will make me to enter into the sin that would drive me to death. You will make me to suffer. You double-minded, you know double-minded is unstable. So double-minded will make you to suffer. Therefore, you have to hate them. You have to hate those double-minded. Even the friends who are double-minded. There are some friends who comes to church, but they are double-minded. They are unstable. They will tell you this and this and this, and then you start following them. So when you start following them, that's the end of your life. That's why the Bible is saying, I hate those who are double-minded. You must hate them. You must hate double-minded. Love the law of God. The law of God will deliver you. And you say evildoers. Evildoers are people who are living in sins. They don't fear sins. They enter in sins too easily. You find church members, people go to church, but it's still they are doing adultery. They are thieves. They are murderers. They are criminals, but they are in the church. That's why double minds do. There's a man of God, a prophet. When he looked at the people and they saw these people, they are double-minded. Let me give them condition and see what they will do. If they are double-minded, it will help them. And then you look at the book of 2 Kings 18, verse 21. Elijah came near to all the people and said, how long will you haste between two opinions? If the Lord is God, follow him. But if Baal, follow him. But the people did not answer him a word. So Elijah, look at these people. They were worshiping other gods, the gods who does not help them. So Elijah tell them, how do you operate with the two minds? Double mind, double opinion. If you want to serve God, serve God. If you want to serve the devil, the Baal, serve him. But the people, they did not say anything because they were double minded. Now, when you look at the book of Isaiah 29, verse 13, the Bible says, Isaiah 29, verse 13, the Bible says, then the Lord says, because these people draw near with their words and honor me with their lips service, but they remove their hearts far from me, and their reverence for me constantly of traditional land by wrath. You see, these people, it is in the Bible, also in the book of, maybe in the book of Luke, where Jesus was telling the people like that, hypocrisy and Pharisees and Sadducees. Now, Isaiah was talking like this. The people, they honor God with their lips. They honor God with talks and honor and say that, yeah, we love God, we love, as I said. But inside, they follow their traditional. They have not given their traditional ways. They are always serving other gods. They go back and say, our traditional. I say, our Kenyan traditional, we believe this and this. We believe every month we sacrifice a man, a god, a sheep, or something to worship, to honor. So when you follow those traditional, it is not traditional of God. that is double-minded and you are at risk. That is sick. That is so wicked and evil. Thank you, Jesus. So double-minded are always people who goes back and look at their traditional. You say, I'm a Nigerian. I'm Nigerians. We Nigerians, we have this and this. Then you are double-minded. We say, we Christian, we follow the law of God. We follow the commandment of God. We follow Jesus Christ. We don't follow our culture. Because our culture, our traditional, would open doors for double-minded. So we have to check how we respond this. Because once you open the door for double-minded, you will become unstable. Nothing will work for you. Remember that. That is what James said. And also, when you come to your traditional, your culture, what your people believes, it is not from the Bible, it's not from God. You open door for double-minded. And once double-minded, you will be, they will overpower you. And they will rule you. But because you have the word, when you are being overpowered and being ruled by the world, so your God will be small. Then their God will be big. Because you open the door and now they are in for you. And they have been watching, they have been waiting for that day that they will get you. When they get it, when they found you, you cannot escape. They will make sure that they have taken your life and take everything from you. Because you are one leg there and another leg there. So they will put the rest of the other leg and then they put two legs together. Now you become unstable, double-minded. Let us see the book of Luke, what Jesus was talking here. In the book of Luke 11, verse 39 to 40. The book of Luke, verse 39 to 40. The Bible says, but the Lord says to him, now you Pharisee, clean the outside of the cup. Clean, hallelujah, praise be the name of Jesus. Let me start again. Hallelujah, Jesus, you are God. But the Lord said to him, now, you Pharisees, clean the outside of the cup and outside and of the plate, but inside of you, you are full of robbery and wickedness. You foolish one, did not he who made the outside make the inside also? Now, you can see Jesus was talking to the Pharisees because the Pharisees were cleaning outside, but inside they are rotten. Inside they are so evil. There are a lot of stuff inside. So Jesus called them. You know, that's why I was telling you, Jesus was talking very bad words. Jesus never talks good words. He looked at them and said, but you inside, you are robbers and wicked. You see people, they dress very well. They are in the church in time. They don't get late. They praise God. They sing. They are in the choir. But inside, they have the spirit of robbery. They are a spirit of wicked. They are looking men who are going to sleep with. They are looking for gods they are going to sleep with. They are looking how they are going to steal. So Jesus was telling them, you are double-minded. You Pharisee, the way I see, you wear the robe. You wake up, you are holding two hands. You walk like you are holy. But inside, you are rotten. So double-minded, that is what they do. They make a person behave like he's so humble, he's so good, he look outside, he's really good, he doesn't miss even the church. He gives his tithe and offering. He is always in activities of God in the church. He participates, always doing activities of God. Or you find one person everywhere, his choir is doing a lot of work in the church, but inside is robber and wickedness. So that people like that, they are double-minded. That's why you find even witchcraft in the church, because they are double-minded. Some people like that, there's nothing good will come to them. They will never get anything good, because you cannot mock God. God is not like that. God is holy God. And if you choose to be double-minded, that is the end of your life. We would pray to God and cry to God to help us to deliver our minds. And Jesus called them, they are foolish because they pretend. Hallelujah. They pretend that they are holy outside. They can, you have you seen somebody really look like he's so holy? He's holy, but inside is God who knows who that person is. People, what the people do outside, when they are alone there, it's God who can tell you. They have boyfriend, girlfriend, they do so wicked. They go to witch doctor, they are greedy, they are jealousy, envy. You find people, they are very angry. They get angry and they are very, very, very jealous in the church because they have double-minded. Double-minded, they will send you to have jealousy, envy, witchcraft, thieves, you prostitute in the church. You become a prostitute while you are in the church. A choir master, he was very anointed man. And when he sings, you will cry. This man, he decided to excuse that he's working, and now he ended up giving up the church and went to the world to sing there. Yeah, he was, when I was in the college in Kenya, he joined our class, but he didn't complete. And we loved him because he was singing good songs. When he sings, you will dance, you will cry. Because he can compose a very good songs. Now, there was a band called Mangreba. Is it Mangreba? Those people from Zaire, they know Mangreba. Or Mangreba, I don't know how to pronounce that word proper. It's a Congo song. Ringara. Yeah, Ringara, something like that. Now, this man decided to go and join the band that came to Kenya to do their music. Then the man, because he was a very good singer, so those people, I don't know how they convinced them, he went and started singing with them. And he resigned from the church because he had double-minded, and the devil found him that he can have him, he will take him. Once you are double-minded, the devil is looking for every opportunity to have you full-time, to have you full. Now these people, they just came and they have him full. And the man started singing and dancing. As I'm talking today, the man died. He's not alive. Because the devil cannot allow him to continue, or God cannot allow him to continue. So double-minded, they end in treachery. Because they are unstable, they can't achieve anything. Where he went to do the song of the world, you can see. Another example is Whitney. You know, this woman, she was in a church and she decided to go and do the songs, the world songs, and forgot about the God that she was serving. Double-minded. That's why you need Whitney Houston. You know, everybody knows Whitney Houston. She was a church choir and she was singing there because she had a very good voice and God was using in the church. Then the devil moved her to go and serve other gods. Because of that, she ended up in treachery. That is what double-minded ended. You end up getting schizophrenia. You end up starting taking drugs. You end up getting rejected. Rejection. People being rejected. You start rejected. You end up being rejected. Because you have the demon, the demon that is in you, that makes you to be rejected. Or you can be accepted because the demon wants to use you. They can love you, and it is double, it's two ways. You can be rejected, or you can be loved and be moved and be taken completely from God. Always, these double-minded, they don't take you back to God. They remove you from God completely to their side. That's why we need to pray. I am praying that God Almighty will deliver you. Rest, repent, and pray God to deliver us. Any double-minded in our hearts, anything double in our lives, let us ask God to forgive us. Let's pray. I'm giving you seconds to ask God to forgive every one of us. If you have anything double in your heart, in your mind, let us ask God to forgive us so that God can deliver us, our mind, in the name of Jesus. Let's pray. Our God, in Jesus' name, I ask you, Lord Jehovah, my Father, to forgive us, to forgive me, to forgive our family, to forgive anyone who is double-minded, who is not stable, who cannot do things by you, Jesus. Double-minded that does not have faith. They don't have faith. They go for help. But God, my Father, help us. Deliver us, Lord, my Father, and forgive us, Lord, for being double-minded, God. We believe you, Lord, my Father, help us. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, deliver us from this double-minded, God. My Father and my God, I thank you. I give you all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Thank you very much. Now I'm going to pray for you. I'm going to pray to you. I'm going to pray that God Almighty will take away that double-minded. I am going to pray the prayers of deliverance, that you will be delivered from double-minded. You will be fighting the enemy outside, and you are the enemy of your soul. You can be fighting the enemy, and the enemy, you are the enemy yourself. So you don't have to divide yourself. You can fight the enemy outside, and you yourself, you are the enemy. I pray that God will deliver you today. I pray that God will pull down the stronghold of conviction in your mind, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray for this person right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pull down the stronghold of conviction on confused in your mind, in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that God will deliver your mind from double mind, in the name of Jesus. I curse you, devil. I curse you, demon. I curse you, disease, in that head, in that mind. I command them to be destroyed in Jesus' name. Every seat of conviction in your mind, I command them to be broken down, to be broken down to pieces in Jesus' name. Every seat, anything that is sitting in your mind, that bring double destruction, that bring double-minded, let them be broken to pieces in Jesus' name. I pray that God Almighty, let the storm of conviction within your mind be still in the name of Jesus. I pray that God Almighty be deliver you from the storm of conviction within your mind in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray for somebody right now by the power in the blood of Jesus. I command every cloud of conviction that has enveloped your mind, vade away now in the name of Jesus. I command every cloud of conviction that has enveloped your mind, vade away now in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, I command every rejected. I command every rejection. I command every rejection spirit that has entered into your mind to be destroyed in Jesus' name. I reject every storm of conviction, and I claim sound-minded in your life in Jesus' name. I claim sound-minded. I command sound-minded to fall upon you, to fall upon your mind in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, every power that wants to destroy your mind, I command you to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Every power want to destroy your mind. Every power want to destroy your ears. Every power want to destroy your eyes. Every power wants to use your mouth. Every power want to destroy you. Want to destroy your mind. I am speaking to you right now. Hear the word of God. Be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Be destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ. Every mind that has been damaged by double-minded, let this spirit to be washed away by the blood of Jesus, in the name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I fire back every arrow of mind destruction fired into your life, back to the sender, in the name of Jesus. We send back to the sender. Wherever that double-minded come from, we send them back to the sender. I fire them back to the sender. I release them back to the sender. You double-minded, wherever I've sent you, I release you back to the sender. I command you to return where you came from in Jesus' name. Leave these people by fire, by thunder, in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, I fire back every arrow of mine, destruction, fired into your life by back to the sender in the name of Jesus Christ. You mind, receive divine touch of God and be revealed in the name of Jesus. You double mind, receive divine touch of God and be relieved in the name of Jesus Christ. Receive touch of God. Receive fire of God. Receive thunder and the fire of God of God in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that double-minded demon, double-minded spirit, double-minded sickness, double-minded diseases, I command you to receive tight, to receive fire, to receive the fire of God to come out from these people in the name of Jesus Christ. I pull down every stronghold of uncontrollable thoughts in your life, in your mind, in Jesus' name. There are some uncontrollable thoughts. When they come, when double mind bring them, nobody will control you. That's when you will think of doing so bad stuff. That's when you can open your mouth and start cursing. You forget that you are not a Christian. You forget that Jesus Christ is your personal savior. You forgot salvation. When this double-minded rise up, you forgot everything. You are uncontrollable. Nobody will control you. Nobody will tell you anything. You become so mad, very arrogant, very pride. Nobody will tell you anything. I command that stronghold of uncontrollable-minded to be destroyed by fire and the hand of God. I am speaking to you right now by the power in the blood of Jesus. Uncontrollable demons, hear the word of God. Get out of this person. I curse you in the name of Jesus Christ. I bind you. I render you powerless. You will not function in the life of this person anymore in the name of Jesus. That's when they come, nobody will control you. Nobody will tell you anything. You decide that nobody will change you. You will never change because they have commanded you that don't change. There's time. The love of God is there. God is full of mercy. God can forgive you and change you completely and you become new creature. God is merciful. God loves you. If this pastor who committed adultery and end up hanging himself, if he give himself a chance to repent and cry to God and ask God, God, I have done this because I've sinned against you. Forgive me, God. Forgive me, God. I am a sinner. Just a simple prayer like that. And humble yourself. Surrender to God. God will come to you and help you and deliver you. God will never leave you. God is looking for people who are humble, who are teachable. But an uncontrollable person, it is very difficult for anybody to help you. Even Jesus cannot help you because you are uncontrollable. How can Jesus help you if you are uncontrollable? Jesus has sent his servant. God has servant people like me, prophets, pastors, to talk to you. But you refuse to obey. You refuse that nobody will tell you anything. So these powers of double-minded is controlling you so much that nobody will control you. Nobody will tell you anything. You need, there's a chance to repent and change. Child of God, I'm talking to you. There is a chance to change. Stop wondering. Stop wasting your money. When you hear a preacher saying, I want somebody to give 1,000 right now. The Spirit of God is moving. I want somebody giving 500, 200 like that. You rest there, you give. You are waiting because of your double-minded. You don't think of everything. You just rush. You've been going to church. You've been accusing pastors. You've been accusing people. Even you have no friend because of double-minded. Double-minded makes people to run away from you. You always accuse people. You always point people. You never appreciate anybody. You will never say thank you to anybody. You always criticize. You always saying bad things to people. You will look at a person and say, look at that person, how it looks like. You start criticizing people. Every church you go, you criticize people. You've been visiting around preachers all over the world. This periscope, you are there 24 hours. You don't miss. Double-minded, that is what they do. They go to TV, they worship the TV. They are Christian, but the remote control is their hand. They are always there watching all this movie, watching all those dirty games, watching all those dirty movie. There's movies now called the African movie. They are satanic. Some of them, they are not godly movie. They are satanic, but you put your hours and hours there, double-minded, that's what they do. Because they are not stable. When they see this, they are there. When you see wild things, you are there. So I pray that God would deliver you. I command that demon to die. I speak the word of the living God right now by the power in the blood of Jesus. I command every area that double-minded have captured. I bring the fire of God to burn them to ashes in Jesus' name. You must be set free, and Jesus will set you free today in Jesus' name. I bind you, the strong man, you demon of double-minded, get out of this person right now in Jesus' name. I break the power of evil remote controlling over your thoughts. Evil remote controlling double-minded over your thoughts. I cut them into pieces. I cut them into pieces. I pray that God will cut them into pieces in the name of Jesus. I pray that God Almighty, I command all imagination contrary to your prayer, life, to be defeated by the power in the blood of Jesus. All imagination that comes to you, double-minded, they bring imagination, and then you force that imagination because they are traveling you. When you force them, they come and overtake you. Therefore, I command them to be destroyed by the fire tongue of God. I command all imagination contrary to your prayer life, to be defeated and fall down and be destroyed in Jesus' name. My God and my Father, I want to thank you. I pray that God will deliver you in the name of Jesus. There's somebody who has been paddling this double-minded. You are on this side and this side. Though today God is going to deliver you. You must be stable. Because double-minded are unstable. You cannot decide anything by yourself. You always going everywhere asking advice. It's good to ask advice, but the Holy Spirit will help you too. You cannot enter to the camp of the enemy to ask advice the enemy. Your enemy. Enemy will say, yes, yes, I know, but he will destroy you forever. That's why many people, their friends, they make them suffer. You tell your friends all the secret, and then you think that this is going to help you. Instead of helping you, he uses against you and destroy you completely in Jesus, in the name of their gods. But by the power in the blood of Jesus, I pray that every unfriendly friends that want to deceive you, let them be disgraced and exposed in Jesus' name. All those evil and the wicked personality you are going to for help, those cannot help you. They are the children of the devil. They are assigned by the devil to lie on you, to be there, to be there, so that when you go there, they will destroy you, your life completely. They will pull you to their group, and then you will not come out. They will give you wrong advice, and they will cheat you and say, God also help those who help themselves. So they will advise you, let's go this, I know somebody, and it's a psychic person, or a false prophet, or a cult. People go to a cult without their knowledge. A friend just say, I know a prophet, a man of God. He's a man of God. He sees everything. He can prophesy to you. Because you are looking for prophecy, you are looking for people to tell you your things. So you go there blindly. When you go there, they pull you completely. They make sure you will not go back where you come from. Therefore, double-minded people, they serve a lot. I am praying that God Almighty will deliver you. It is a disease. It is a disease. Therefore, I destroy every disease, every spiritual disease of double-minded in your mind in Jesus' name. I bind them, I delete them, I render them powerless in Jesus' name. I want to thank God so much for you. God is almighty. God is so good. Remember the scripture says, study the word of God. Go and study these scriptures. Go yourself and look at the scripture and study them. Pray God to deliver you from double-minded. Because one time it will take you and finish you completely if you are not careful. If you are double, you have to decide from now, who are you going to serve? Moses asked the people today to choose whom they will serve. Joshua called the people and Moses called the people and asked the people, today tell me, whom are you going to choose? Choose whom you can serve. Either you want to serve God or your gods. The people says, we will serve God. Moses says, me and my house will serve God. Moses declared that he will serve his God. So if people, you don't want to serve God, that's fine. But if you want to serve God, serve God. Don't be double-minded. Serve the Lord, our God. Serve Almighty God. He is a good God. He will help you. He will never leave you. People of God, I tell you that if you serve God with your whole heart, remember the scripture tell us, serve God with all your heart, with all your strength, with all your soul. But when you are double-minded, you don't serve God like that. Because halfway is on the other side and halfway in the other side. So you are not fully. You are not full serving God. Serve God with all your heart. Then God will help you. I thank you for everything that you are doing to God. God help you. God help us. God deliver us from these diseases of spiritual double-minded mind. God bless you so much. See you tomorrow, 8 o'clock. The videos are there. It is going to come up within 15 minutes today. And God will help you. Remember, I have my party day is coming 20th of this month. We will celebrate at the same time we have our anniversary. Therefore, people of God, thank you so much. I see people, they are responding, and I love you so much. You know, I love you. I love you with the love of God, and I know that God loves you more than me. So you are my people. Therefore, I pray that you come to celebrate with me. Also, remember, we have a 6 weeks training, Overcomers Deliverance Training School. It will help you and change your life. I have the class going on, and many people, they are very happy. I got many people who have registered all over the world, and they discover things they don't know. You need this training. God will help you. Even if you don't have money, you can pay even $20, $10. Slowly, slowly, you will finish the course. Don't think that I am desperately need money. Because I take time and I have materials, that's why I'm asking you to pay that. If otherwise, I can give you free. But I have materials and I take my time. So that's why you have to give away a donation. You have to appreciate. You can pay little, not necessary to pay a whole amount. Some people were calling to ask me, can I pay literally? I said, yes. Register and pay wherever you have until you finish. I will not deny anything. Once you know, pay is a discipline that you will complete the course and you will use. This training cost me a lot of money. I went to school so many, I've studied a lot. So I